Guess what?
What? I've
got something very exciting to tell you.
Tell us.
You know, because you're in the office, okay. But starting Monday, it's the project's makeover week.
Ooh.
Yep. Now, since our beloved Paddy won't be here all week, like we've had him for the last 2 weeks, we thought we'd give him a taste of what we might expect. But I don't think anyone really expected what you're about to see.
Hi, I'm Medulla Oblongata, and I'm here to make over investigative journalist Paddy Gower.
Ooh. Right, I know that I'm probably meant to say that I'm feeling nervous, but I'm not. I'm actually bloody excited to do this. It's going to be a huge, huge, huge privilege to do something totally different. Yeah, you're putting quite a lot on there, Medulla. Do I need all that glue?
You don't need all of that. In order to make you look as pretty as we're going to use it anyway.
This might sound a little weird, but I'm starting to feel quite sexy.
Well, she's finally coming through.
It's funny, you're actually becoming more beautiful.
The more you look at me?
Yeah, the deeper I go inside this sensual world. What are you doing at the moment?
I'm just putting a little bit of gold glitter to tie in with your dress later.
Oh, yeah, so my makeup will match my dress. What does this transformation do for you as a person?
Well, Oscar Wilde said, give the man a mask and he will tell you the truth. And I quite often treat drag as a mask where I can be my most authentic self.
It makes you feel real.
It makes me be real. I know that you are known for your lips, but we're going to give you a bigger top lip.
A bigger top lip?
A bigger top
lip. Oh, yeah, yeah. Don't make the bottom one any bigger.
No, not at all.
So is this the first time you've taken like a regular Kiwi bloke and transformed him?
Oh, no, not at all. I do this quite often for stags at the stag do's.
Oh, stags.
Yeah.
They love it, do they?
They love dressing up like a woman.
Hey, so you're from the Maldives. How did you end up here in New Zealand?
Well, I came to New Zealand as a refugee because the Maldives is a 100% Muslim country and I have renounced Islam and I'm queer, so therefore, in order to be safe, I had to come to New Zealand.
What's the difference between a drag queen and someone who is trans?
Trans is who you are, drag is what you do. I am gender neutral, I am everything and nothing all at once.
I feel beautiful without even seeing myself. Wow! Holy shit! Yeah! That's amazing! I'm gonna cry, but I'm gonna ruin the makeup. These chest hairs are not ideal.
It creates a shadow.
We should have waxed them.
Should have waxed them, yeah. But it creates a shadow. It makes you look like, you know, you've got some cleavage happening.
Yeah, yeah.
Special kind of person to feel comfortable with their gender and their sexuality to actually do that. So well done. And then to me, it seemed like you were really moved emotionally, spiritually. Talk us through what was going on.
Yeah, I mean, it was just amazing that Medulla put so much effort in and it meant so much to her to transform me.
Mm.
And when you saw me nearly crying there, that was because she had given me my drag name. So her full name is Medulla Oblongata, which is a part of the brain. And she told me that my name was not something like Patty Power or all these things that we thought of. My name was Caudate Nucleus, which is another part of the brain.
Caudate Nucleus?
Said, yes, and she said that made me part of her family. And she'd been waiting to give that name to someone for many years. And I just want to say to Medulla, I'm so proud to be part of your family. You taught me a lot today. You taught me how to bring joy to people just by looking a bit different. But you also taught me about the simplest thing to remember in life, which is we are all the same on the inside.
Absolutely. She was really, really cool.
Thank you so much, Medulla.
You're a bit like part of my family as well, because you look very much like my Auntie Mildred when they'd finished with you. So that was quite moving for me as well.
Yeah.
Also, today wouldn't have happened, obviously, without Medulla. She's amazing. But Hairology by Carl for
incredible
providing that
hair.
Beautiful wig
incredible
that Patty was wearing.
Can't wait to wear it tomorrow.